This is Unhinged, a Cora Shields suspense thriller, book 3. Written by Blake Pierce, narrated by Emma A. Gould. Prologue. Ignoring the sobbing from the other room, Mindy stood outside the shower and turned the knob. She pulled her hand back sharply to avoid the initial burst of frigid spray. Then, still wearing her bathrobe, she turned to face the mirror, poking and prodding at what looked suspiciously like bags under her eyes. The sounds from the room only increased in volume. She sighed, listening for a few more moments. Then the door clicked and the sobbing faded. Finally. The guy had been sitting on the bed for nearly half an hour, inconsolable. Some of the clients just got like that after a session, but they paid all the same. And that was what mattered. Mindy adjusted her two clip-on earrings, then removed them slowly, putting the fake emerald things in a small tray above the sink. She ran a hand along her ear, wincing. An aversion to needles, some called it. Common sense, in her opinion. She'd never had a piercing. No tattoos either. That was one of the selling points, it turned out, for some of her clients. She peeked back through the small motel bedroom, eyeing the door. Gone. The client was gone. Gone. Mercifully gone. She finally allowed a sigh of relief and a smile. She darted out of the bathroom, hurried to the door, locked it, then returned. She paused for a second, frowning and ducking to check under the bed. One could never be too careful in her line of work. Sometimes Johns could be resourceful in their desire to get a few extra seconds with a preferred escort. Escort. Lady of the night. She snorted. Damn old whore. That's how she saw it, and she didn't think anything less of the job because of it. She wasn't in this for being down on her luck, or out of any sense of daddy issues. Mindy was here because the money was good. And it sure as hell beat to death with a wooden spoon the last job she'd had, where she risked fry grease in the eye and handsy drunk customers late at night. At least this way, they paid for the privilege. She returned to the bathroom, shutting the door. By now, the steam had formed and was fogging the mirror. She studied her face. Not exactly pretty, but not ugly either. Right down the middle. Good enough. She smirked and began to turn towards the shower, one hand adjusting the belt on her bathrobe. And that's when she heard the creak. She frowned, freezing in place and listening like a startled rabbit. Another creak. This time the sound of the door. She wrinkled her nose, beginning to turn. Had the John returned? Damn it, hadn't she locked the door? Footsteps now. Rapid. She spun as the door to the bathroom suddenly crashed open. She stared out in the bedroom, eyes the size of saucers. A sudden scream burst from her throat. The man with a dark hood and a grotesque horror shop mask, like some gargoyle, was leering in at her. A second man crowded in behind the first, also marching forward. They didn't hesitate at her scream, nor when she desperately searched behind her, groping in the shower for something to use as a weapon. Help! Help! She screeched. Terror flooded her system. The two men grabbed at her, hands like vices on her wrists. She tried to stomp on their feet, but they were both wearing big, hefty boots. She tried to scratch at their hands, but their grip was too strong. It was difficult to even think amidst the terror. As she continued to scream, they dragged her through the door, as indifferent to her howling as if she wasn't making a sound. Chapter 1. Cora marched up the small trail through the woods, glancing eerily from side to side, searching the trees for any hidden threats. Normally, she wouldn't take meetings away from familiar territory. But now that she was back in West Virginia, her old childhood stomping grounds, she felt familiar enough with most terrain. Plus, Gabriel Finch had sounded urgent on the phone. She grumbled a bit, kicking a pine cone off the path and wondering why the hell her parents had given her number to her sister's old ex in the first place. The motion caused her to stop, wincing. She reached up, massaged her bandaged shoulder, then glanced down at the white gauze wrapped around her arm. The doctor said that it was healing nicely enough. She had been forced to cycle through 2 general practitioners until she found someone who didn't keep prying about the source of the gunshot wounds.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.